Hello YouTube, today I wanted to show you an uncommon system here in the US. It was known as a Wonder Mega 2 in Japan, but when JVC brought it out, they called it the JVC X'Eye. Now the X'Eye was supposed to be a multimedia type system, as the 3DO was and whatnot. It was supposed to do other than games. Basically, they wanted to emphasize that it could play CDs and CD+Gs on top of the Sega CD games and Genisis games that it was able to run. As far as this system was concerned, JVC had a part in making the Sega CD back in the day, and as far as their collaboration goes, they were able to bring out this system since they helped out in the project of making the Sega CD. Compared to the Sega CD though, this one here actually has a better audio output as far as the CD games are concerned. It has something called dynamic range, which gave it a broader band as far as the sound signals went. So you did have a sharper sound in your audio quality. Let me just show you the system as far as what it had available as far as its outputs went. You did have your volume control here, and that was in reference to your phono jack. If you notice here, there's also a mic output, and that was for anybody who had CD+Gs. CD+Gs were actually pretty big back in the day as far as karaoke was concerned, and you could use that in order to sing along with your songs when you had them connected to here. If you notice, it has a standard composite, which wasn't common with the Genisis models. But if you did have the connections for the Genisis 2, this one here would be able to run through those cables as well. Now this little hole here, if you notice, that there, I'm not sure why they took out, but the Japanese model, you were able to run S video signal. I guess they didn't think it was too common here in the US at the time. So yeah, that was removed, which I thought was a bummer. And of course, the plug output. This uses a 9.5 volt. A lot of people, they mistakenly put the Genisis 2 adapter in here because it fits, but it'll actually overpower the system and overheat it. Yeah, I've tried it before, and I'm actually running this on a different adapter now. But yeah, this section here would get really hot if you plugged it in using the Genisis 2 adapter. Now, as far as the controllers go, I mean, it pretty much says it all that it's a Sega Genisis. The controller is exactly the same, except for this logo here, which says JVC. And the control, it says control pad RGCP10 on the top. But yeah, I'm not sure why they included these, because when this came out, the 6-button controller was already around. But yeah, as far as games went, like I said, this is the cartridge port and the CD port, of course. If you had a game in here, of course the CD version or the CD part would not run. It would not access, just like the Sega Genisis. And there you go, just like a Turbo Duo or PC Engine Duo. You know, you got both the best worlds on there. As far as plugs went, if you recall, the Sega CD actually needed its own power source on top of having the base unit being powered as well. So you had two adapters as opposed to one. So yeah, this alleviates a lot of the clutter. If you could get your hands on one of these, and if you're a fan of Sega CD or Sega Genisis, yeah, these here are not very common, but you won't find them for a premium online. But yeah, it does cut out the clutter, and it works with all the accessories that the Sega CD and the Sega Genesis run with, same plugs and whatnot. So yeah, I just want to show you that, because I don't see too many of these out there. Thanks for watching.